At 2:07 p.m. local time on July 11th, something unexpected occurred at Italy's erupting Mount Stromboli volcano. Instead of producing one of its many so-called Strombolian-style eruptions which eject bombs of lava to a modest height, an eruption type 1,000 times more powerful occurred. In other words, a major explosion unexpectedly took place, fragmenting overlying rock into fine particles of ash, throwing large boulders of rock more than 100 meters away, and generating a strong shockwave that rattled structures on the island as 37,000 cubic meters of rock was ejected. As the associated eruption column rose to an altitude of 3,048 meters or 10,000 feet, part of the erupted material was too dense to rise on a buoyant column of air and thus collapsed back to the ground, generating a pyroclastic flow which swept down Stromboli's steep northwestern slope. Advancing at a speed of 85 kilometers per hour, the several hundred degrees Celsius pyroclastic flow only took 50 seconds to enter the Mediterranean Sea, at which point it traveled outwards over the water for several hundred meters. Strong eruptive tremor subsequently ended only 8 minutes after it began, ending an uncommon event known as a paroxysm. What had just occurred was not only Mount Stromboli's largest eruption in 5 years, but also a classic example of an eruption type associated with the name of a neighboring island, a Vulcanian eruption. The term Vulcanian eruption was originally invented to describe eruptions observed on the island of Volcano, which occurred between 1888 and 1890. It describes a process where erupted material or some form of debris temporarily blocks a magma conduit. Pressure then builds up underneath the blockage until it either dislodges or fragments the blocking material, causing rapidly fragmenting lava to transition into a sustained ash-rich eruption column. These eruptions often generate pyroclastic flows and tend to eject between 1,000 and 1 million cubic meters of material. In contrast, Strombolian eruptions tend to only eject between 10 and 100 cubic meters of volcanic rock, being caused by rising gas bubbles ascending through a magma conduit and then bursting as shown in this footage. Since Mount Stromboli tends to produce a Strombolian-style eruption every 5 to 30 minutes, how did it produce a Vulcanian eruption? The answer relates to its underlying magma chambers, which actually provided a form of warning beforehand on the surface that a powerful explosive event might occur. Underneath Mount Stromboli, there are two magma chambers, one at 2 to 4 kilometers depth and the other at 7 to 10 kilometers depth, which are interconnected. The upper magma chamber is crystal-rich, volatile-poor, and gas-poor, while the lower magma chamber is crystal-poor, volatile-rich, and gas-rich. Typically, the gas-poor magma in the upper magma chamber feeds Stromboli's weaker Strombolian eruptions, although it still contains enough gas content to create minor explosive activity. However, every once in a while, the lower, deeper magma chamber will receive a new batch of molten rock originating from the upper mantle. This eventually causes some of the high gas content magma to rise and begin mixing with the upper magma chamber, causing the frequency of Strombolian events to increase on the surface. Eventually, sufficient high gas and high volatile content magma is present in the upper magma chamber that it can feed distinctive events, displacing the less dense crystal-rich magma upwards. When this occurs, brief or prolonged episodes of near-continuous Strombolian fountaining can occur, although the formation of unusually large lava flows is far more likely. You might notice that these two features were observed multiple times in the last 2 weeks at Mount Stromboli, which is not a coincidence, although not all lava flows indicate the next step. Once the high gas and high volatile magma starts rising through the magma conduit, it encounters a blockage. It then only becomes a matter of time, generally around 45 minutes, until enough pressure builds that a large Vulcanian eruption occurs. While Vulcanian eruptions are the norm for volcanoes such as Sakurajima in Japan or Fuego in Guatemala, at Stromboli these events are rare, having only occurred 5 times during the last 60 years. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, Mr. Black, for supporting this channel.